Welcome to Once Upon a Pipe, this Memorial Day 2020. I would like to share with you a poem written by Theodore O'Hara called Bivouac of the Dead. Perhaps you've heard of it. The muffled drum's sad roll has beat the soldier's last tattoo. No more on life's parade shall meet that brave and fallen crew. On fame's eternal camping ground, their silent tents are spread. And glory guards with solemn round the bivouac of the dead. No rumor of the foe's advance now swells upon the wind. No troubled thought at midnight haunts of loved ones left behind. No vision of the morrow's strife, the warrior's dream alarms. No brain horn or screaming fife at dawn shall call to arms. Their shivered swords are red with rust. Their plumed heads are bowed. Their haughty banner, trailed in dust, is now their martial shroud. And plenteous funeral tears have washed the red stains from each brow. And the proud forms by battle gashed and free from anguish now. The neighing troop, the flashing blade, the bugle's stirring blast, the charge, the dreadful cannonade, the din and shout are past. Now war's wild note, nor glory's peal, shall thrill with fierce delight those breasts that nevermore shall feel the rapture of the fight. Like the fierce northern hurricane that sweeps his great plateau, flushed with the triumph yet to gain, came down the serried foe, who heard the thunder of the fray break o'er the field beneath, knew well the watchword of that day was victory or death. Long had the doubtful conflict rage o'er all that stricken plain, for never fiercer fight had waged the vengeful blood of Spain. And still the storm of battle blew, still swelled the glory tide. Not long were stout or old chieftain knew such odds his strength could abide. 'Twas in that hour his stern command called to a martyr's grave the flower of his beloved land, the nation's flag to save. By rivers of their father's gore his firstborn laurels grew, and well he deemed the sons would pour their lives for glory too. Full many a northerner's breath was swept o'er Agnostura's plain, and long the pitying sky has swept above its moldered slain. The raven's scream or eagle's flight or shepherd's pensive lay alone awakes each sullen height that frowned o'er that dread fray. Sons of the dark and bloody ground, ye must not slumber there, where stranger steps and tongues resound along the heedless air. Your own proud land's heroic soil shall be your fitter grave. She claims from war his richest spoil, the ashes of her brave. Thus, neath her parent turf they rest, far from the glory field, born to a Spartan's mother's breast on many a bloody shield. The sunshine of their native sky smiles sadly on them here, and kindred eyes and hearts watch by the hero's sepulchre. Rest on, embalmed and sainted dead, dear as the blood ye gave. No impious footsteps here shall tread the herbage of your grave, nor shall your glory be forgot while fame her record keeps, or honor points the hallowed spot where valor proudly sleeps. Yon marble minstrel's voice's stone in deathless song shall tell, when many a vanquished year hath flown, the story how ye fell. Nor wreck, nor change, nor winter's blight, nor time's remorseless doom can dim one ray of holy light that gilds your glorious tomb. The Bivouac of the Dead by Theodore O'Hara.